I'm going to show you the substandard practice and building materials that the builder uses to build your shower and what I do to make a waterproof shower that will last for years to come. Stick around, you're not going to want to miss it. What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. We are in Milton working for new clients of mine, Ian and Jennifer. We are doing a partial master ensuite remodel. Now, it is a partial remodel because we are not replacing the vanity or the drop-in soaker tub. But what sparked this remodel is a crack that appeared in the concrete slope of their shower floor. Now, when I met with my clients initially, I advised them, do not continue to use your shower because it's eventually going to leak and it's going to cause more damage than you already have. So unfortunately for them, they have not used their shower for the past 8 months. But today we are ready to get started. We're ready to start demo. My clients are super excited to get started. But in this video, I'm going to show you why the subdivision builder showers leak. I'm going to show you all the substandard material and building practice that they use. Unfortunately, it meets minimum code and that's why they get away with it. But we are going to remodel this shower with all new waterproofing product that's absolutely superior over the method that the builder uses. As well, we're installing all new tile in the shower, the tub surround, the tub skirt, and on the bathroom floor, as well as new quartz countertops, frameless glass, real bell shower fixture. But before we get started with demo, let's go inside and have a look. I'm standing in our master ensuite. So as I mentioned before, we're doing a 4 foot by 4 foot custom shower. You can see here how the concrete slope has deteriorated over the years. The concrete is cracked. So before it starts leaking into the kitchen, we're gonna do Wedi waterproofing throughout, custom frameless glass as well. The tub is staying. We're gonna do a new tile tub surround. The vanity is also staying, but we're gonna replace it with a beautiful quartz countertop, double vanity. It's gonna look amazing when it's finished. So let's not waste no time, let's start getting to demo. So first things first, I'm gonna carefully remove the builder's shower glass. A few screws to take the frame apart and then carefully cut the silicone to remove the glass panels. Next, using an Allen key, I'm going to remove the faucet handle and the escutcheon plate. Thank you.
Without using any tools, I will easily remove the gooseneck shower head. So I want to create as little damage to the surrounding drywall and door frame as possible. So I'm going to use my mini reciprocating saw and cut the edge of the tile. I don't want to damage any of the plumbing in behind the wall, so I'm going to carefully start smashing out the ceramic tile and fiberboard tile backer with my hammer. When the tile backer was initially installed, they used nails to secure it to the framework. Now, because all the nail heads have rusted away over time, I'm able to pull off all the tile backer and tile off the walls very easily.
Take a moment from demo and go over a couple things with everybody. So first of all, people always ask me, why do I use Wedi shower waterproofing? It's so expensive, you should use dry pack and rubber liner. Well, there's a reason why I don't use dry pack. Now in 12 years, I've done over 250 bathrooms, a majority of them master ensuites and builder grade showers. So this is very typical. I see this every single time. Now, mind you though, I did used to do dry pack and rubber liner showers all the time. But when I discovered the Wedi product, I found it was far more superior and I started using the Wedi and I never looked back. When the builder does the dry pack and waterproof membrane, they skip a couple of steps. The problem is when you skip those steps, you get cracking, you get water penetration, you get mold. The proper way to do a rubber liner and dry pack shower slope is rubber liner at least 12 to 16 inches up each side of the wall. You can see here is about 12 inches. That wall there is barely 6 inches and it's supposed to overlap onto the curb. But before you do your rubber liner, you're supposed to do a pre-slope of dry pack. You do a pre-slope, you put your rubber liner, and then you do your final dry pack slope. But before you do that, you're supposed to put pea gravel around the drain. The drain has weep holes, so if water does penetrate in between the two slopes in the rubber liner, the water will find its way to the drain and whip through the weep holes and the pea gravel. The two steps that the builder always skips is the pre-slope and the pea gravel. Now, I can almost guarantee that if the customer was still using this shower, they haven't used it in about 8 months, that if I broke up this concrete, that I would find water sitting in between the dry pack slope and the rubber liner. But this will come out so easy, I don't even need a jackhammer to take it out. Basically, all I need is a little sledgehammer and a crowbar. So I'm gonna go ahead, remove it, and then I'll pause again, and I'll show you what we found. Also, another thing, actually, before I go ahead continue with demo, this was the last row of tile where the wall met the dry pack slope. And you can see here that the fiber board that they used, it just crumbles. It's actually very moist still, but it just basically crumbles. The proper way to have protected this would have been to do a roll-on rubberized membrane like a Red Guard or Laticrete, but in this case they did not. And then of course, they use glue or mastic to install the tile. Well, mastic is not meant for a wet area. It's also organic and it causes mold growth as well. But this is all garbage. Let's take this out. Like I said, we'll pause the demo and I'll show you what I found. Okay, so here's even something else I want to point out. When the tile setter installed the marble curb, they didn't notch the cement. When you notch the cement, it creates suction and it helps hold down the shower sill before the cement actually dries. The proper way to have done this would have been to back butter the back side of the marble sill and then notch the cement on the curb. In this case, there's no back butter and they basically blobbed it, or what we like to call in the industry, cookie dabbers or cookie dough. This does not hold down the shower sill. As you saw, I pulled it up very easily with my hands. But again, not the right way to do it. We're gonna do it the right way, but let's continue with demo.
I can only assume that the shower curb wasn't leveled properly because the tile installer used scrap tile to level the marble sill.
So just as I expected, no pre-slope underneath the rubber liner. Of course, no pea gravel around the drain body. Yes, that is black mold. They used a metal lath and scratch coat to adhere the tile to the tub deck versus using a fiberboard tile backer, so I will have to use my chipping gun to remove it.
Now that the shower and tub deck tile is completely demoed, I'm going to move on to removing the tile on the bathroom floor. It is also adhered with a screen and scratch coat, but because of poor installation, it comes up fairly easily using the chipping gun.
It is the next day. All our demo is done. Our shower enclosure, our tub deck and tub surround, our floor tile, everything looks great. Everything came out pretty easy. There was a little bit of mold on the back of the drywall of the tub skirting, but the actual plywood structure of the tub deck is in good shape, so nothing to worry about there. Today we're going to install our new REODEL shower valve. As well, we're going to head over to Factory Tile Depot and pick up all our Wedi waterproofing for the shower and the tub deck. The existing shower is 4 foot by 3 feet. We're going to enlarge it to 4 feet by 4 feet, which means we have to recenter the drain. But before we do all that, let's get our shower valve installed so that way we can head over to Factory Tile.
After shutting off the water main, I'm going to replace the existing shower valve with a REODEL thermostatic shower valve with a two-way diverter for a shower head and slide bar. I'm going to add some 2x4 backing so that way our shower valve is nicely secured. So before I head over to Factory Tile Depot, I want to close up the ceiling. I'm going to add a piece of mold and mildew resistant green board. Now I'm going to find center of the shower and drill out a 4-inch hole, then pull out the existing feed for our shower light and install a new IC rated pot light in our shower. So our existing shower was 3 foot by 4 foot, but we want to increase our shower to 4 foot by 4 foot, which means we have to take away some of the tub deck to increase the size of our shower.
All right, everyone, you can see I've already lopped out the existing plumbing drain and I've cut back the tub deck. So from the tub deck to the side wall here, we now have 48 inches. Unfortunately, from the back wall to the front, because the door jamb is here, we don't have 48 inches. We have a little bit less, and we still have to account for the 5-inch shower curb. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut the Wedi pan down, and that's the beauty about using Wedi. The shower pan, you can modify it. So we're gonna cut it down, so that way we can determine where our new drain assembly is gonna go. So let's get the Wedi shower pan cut down so that way we can get our drain assembly installed.
So as I mentioned, the beauty of using Wedi is that you can modify it. It's extruded styrofoam, so you can use an X-Acto knife, a skill saw, or even a handsaw. I make a couple of measurements and I cut it down to the size I need and then dry fit it.
So we got our Wedi shower pan test fitted and it fits perfect. We're 24 inches on center from the mixer wall as well as the tub deck and 21 inches on center from the back wall and the shower curb. Next, we're going to remove it and we're going to plumb in our new shower drain so that way we can get our Wedi pan permanently installed.
The Wedi drain is made up of a couple of components. The drain itself, a gasket, and a locking ring. I add Wedi joint sealant to the underside of the drain, remove any excess, and then apply the gasket and the locking ring to the underside. It only needs to be hand snug. Next, I'm going to mix up some thinset using Laticrete's 4XLT modified gray thinset. I'm going to add quite a bit of water because I want my thinset to have the consistency of mayonnaise. I'm going to wipe down the substrate with a damp sponge before I put down my thinset for a couple of reasons. One, I want my substrate clean and free of any dust or debris. And two, by adding moisture to the substrate, it'll prevent the wood from sucking any moisture out of the thinset, causing the thinset to dry prematurely and compromising the bond between the Wedi shower pan and the subfloor. Then I will use a 1/4 inch notch trowel to spread the thinset. So just like the subfloor, I will use the flat edge of my trowel to work the thinset into the bottom of the shower pan. Then I will use the 1/4 inch notch side and spread the thinset all in one direction. Because I notch the thinset mortar in the same direction on the substrate as well as the underside of the shower pan, when I lay the shower pan down, all the air will squeeze out, creating suction and holding our shower pan firmly in place. After checking to make sure our Wedi shower pan is completely level, I will add 2 50-pound bags of thinset mortar to help weigh it down while it dries. So once again, the same process applies for the shower curb. I will notch the thinset on the substrate as well as the underside of the shower curb. I will add Wedi joint sealant into the channel and then I will make sure it is level and has proper pitch inwards towards the shower. So it is the next day and our Wedi shower pan is completely dry, which means we can start closing up our shower. I will add Wedi joint sealant to the channel and then I will slip in the Wedi building panel into the channel. I will spread out the Wedi joint sealant to create a proper seal and then I will affix the building panel to the wall with the supplied screws and washer. Now that our shower is completely waterproofed, I want to get my Laticrete Stratamat uncoupling membrane laid down on the floor. So same process, I will use a damp sponge to clean the substrate of any dust and debris. I will mix my thinset to a mayonnaise consistency and use a 1/4-inch notch trowel. Then I will unroll my pre-cut uncoupling membrane, and I will use my 75-pound weighted roller to squeeze out any air. The uncoupling membrane is used to allow for substrate movement without cracking your finished tile surface.
What is going on, everyone? It is the next day. Our Wedi waterproofing is done. All our Stratamat uncoupling membrane is done, which basically means this bathroom is ready for tile. On the shower walls and the tub surround, we're going with this 3x12 New York bright white. We're doing it in a soldier course pattern versus your traditional staggered or subway pattern. For the shower floor, we're going with a 2x2 white hexagon, pretty standard. And for our bathroom floor, we're doing this 8x32 willow perla in a random staggered pattern. It's going to look great when it's done. My tile setters, Ralph and Alfonso, should be here any minute. So I'm going to get all the material upstairs, all the thin set, all the tile. So that way when they get here, they can start tiling. So let's not waste no time. Let's get to work.
So starting with our shower floor, we're going with a white thin set made by Laticrete. It's their Tri-Light, and it's a lightweight, high-performance thinset mortar for thin bed tile application. Using the flat side of the trowel, we're going to work the thin set into the Wedi shower pan and then use the 3/16 notch side of the trowel to spread our thin set. Now that our shower floor is done, we're going to move on to the bathroom floor tile. We are laying it in a random staggered pattern. We're going to dry fit all our tile first because we want to start at the back wall where the toilet is. So that way we wind up with a full tile at the bathroom door. For the bathroom floor, we are using Laticrete 4XLT Gray mixed to a peanut butter consistency. We are going to use the flat side of the trowel to back butter the underside of our tile, as well as spread the thin set into the Laticrete uncoupling membrane. And then we're going to use the 1/2-inch notch side of the trowel to spread our thin set so we can lay our tile. When laying our tile, we want to make sure we have at least 95% coverage, which means we want to ensure that we have a good bond between our tile and our mortar bed. So periodically, Ralph will lift individual tile to check coverage and add any extra thin set if necessary. Thank you. Now that the bathroom floor is done, we're going to move on to the shower walls. And unlike the bathroom floor, when tiling shower walls, gravity is not your friend. So we do the reverse. We back butter the shower walls and we notch the backside of the tile. Now that all the tile is done, we're going to start with grouting. For the shower walls and the tub skirt and tub surround, we are going with a laticrete unsanded. And for the shower floor and bathroom floor, we will go with a sanded grout. The boys from Provincial, Granite, and Quartz are here to install the new quartz countertop supplied by Superstone. It has beautiful veining throughout, as well as dual undermount porcelain sinks.
Alright everyone, it's about 3.5 days later and my tile setters, Ralph and Alfonso, did an amazing job. All the tile is done and grouted and it looks fantastic. My clients are super happy. As well, you've seen Provincial, Granite, and Quartz come in and install the quartz countertop and that also looks fantastic. My clients love it. In the meantime, now that all the tile is done, Provincial, Quartz, and Granite has to come back in and template for the quartz that goes around the tub deck. Once that's installed, Shower Avenue can come in and template for the shower glass. We're not going to get the quartz sills for the tub deck for a couple of days. So in the meantime, we're going to get all the baseboard trim installed. We're going to plumb the vanities and we're going to get the shower fixture installed as well. That'll give us something to do over the course of the next couple of days while we wait for the quartz for the tub deck. So let's not waste no time. Let's get to work.
For the shower fixture, we're going with the Real Bell Equinox series in matte black. I love using Real Bell. They're a great product, made in Canada. It is a thermostatic valve with a two-way diverter. I'm going to start with the supply for the slide bar wand. I'm going to connect it to the brass extension with some Teflon tape and screw it into place. Then I'm going to take a few measurements to mark where our mounting holes will be for our slide bar. Then I will go ahead and use a diamond bit and drill through the tile and mount the slide bar. Next, I will install the 16-inch extension and the rain head. Moving on to the shower valve, I will remove the brass locking nut and the temporary plug, then insert the new shower valve and reinstall the brass locking nut. We want to be careful not to over tighten the locking nut. We just want to lightly snug it into place. Next, I will slip on the black excursion sleeve and locking ring. Then I will open up the hot and cold water supply that are located on the valve body. And then I will install the excursion seal and excursion plate. Next, I will install the diverter handle using the supplied Allen key, as well as the temperature control knob. I finally received the quartz for the tub deck from Provincial Granite and Quartz. They are cut precisely, but I'm going to dry fit them just to make sure that everything fits correctly. So just like tile installation, I'm going to mix up some Laticrete Tri-Lite in a peanut butter consistency, and I'm going to use a 1/4-inch notch trowel, and I'm going to notch the thinset on the tub deck as well as notch the thinset on the back of the quartz. So before I install the last piece, I'm gonna mix up a little bit of epoxy to add to the seams of each piece of quartz. And last is the shower curb. I will use a 1/4 inch notch trowel on the curb itself, as well as the underside of the quartz sill. Then I will make sure it's level and has proper pitch into the shower. And last, to finish off this bathroom remodel, Shower Avenue is in to install the 10 millimeter frameless shower glass.
That is going to be our wrap for this video. I hope you got something out of this video, this step-by-step master ensuite facelift. You've seen how we took a builder's leaking shower and completely waterproofed it using Wedi waterproofing. My new clients, Ian and Jennifer, absolutely love the transformation. They're super excited to finally get to use their shower. They haven't used it in like 8 months,
In the meantime, the quartz countertops, the custom shower, the frameless glass, the tile clip surround look fantastic. I want to thank all my amazing trades and suppliers. I want to thank Factory Tile Depot, my exclusive tile supplier. They supplied all the tile for this project. I want to thank Ralph and Alfonso, my tile setters. They did an amazing job setting all the tile. I want to thank Platinum Kitchens and Bath for supplying the shower fixture. I want to thank Provincial, Granite, and Quartz. They supplied the quartz countertop and the quartz for the shower sill and the tub deck. I want to thank Shower Avenue for supplying the frameless shower glass. In the meantime, if you like this video, please like, share, comment, and subscribe. I would really appreciate it. It would really help out the channel. I've got more exciting projects and content coming your way. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Facebook. I want to say thank you to all my clients and followers for all the love and support. I want everyone to stay safe, be healthy. We'll see you in the next one. Ciao.
Alfie.
Yeah.
What does YES spell?
Yes.
What does EYES spell?
EY eyes.
Oh, smart. I thought I was going to get you.
Not me, pal.
Wait, what's the usual response?
ES.
You see? That's what cameras are, all fake. Why don't you take the real damn thing, reality, not fake.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
You see?
So,
No. See, real, there's nothing better than real. Real is the truth, and the truth shall set you free.
Hey,
everything else is fake.
Whatever's filmed is not fake. It's still real.
It's edited.
Still real, though.
It's like when everybody smile for the picture. You smile. This is me.
This is the old thing.
This is me, the grumpy old man.
You know, Halloween, the guy said that across the street. I said, "What's wrong, Alfie?" The guy goes, "How's the grumpy old man?" Wait till your freaking kids grow up. Wait. And then you see.